Hello everybody, my name is Flexus and welcome to another video. Today we are going to talk about bodybuilding. I've gotten a lot of questions lately about how to gain muscles, how to build a good physique, and from people who's just stuck, and from people who's just getting started to going to the gym and having some fun lifting some weights. So today I was thinking that I was going to break down those questions and just explain what I think. I've been breaking down this into some categories that I think is really, really the key. You really have to understand. The first thing that I'm going to talk about is mentality. And this is the most valuable key to building a great physique, because the mentality is what's showing on the outside. It's how big your inside is that will determine how big your outside will be. My first topic of this category is your discipline. How bad do you want this? Motivation can only get you so far. Motivation won't help you go down to the gym when you don't wanna. It won't help you to say no to alcohol, to say no to fast food and things that, you know, who won't get you to those places that you want to go. And I strongly believe that your mentality is way more important to understand than how to lift the weight. I think that's really the really biggest key here, is your mentality. Like, motivation will get you started. But discipline will keep you going. Discipline is when a habit becomes a must. When you do stuff that you really don't want to do because you know that the end goal is much more important than what you feel about right now. Because your mind is your biggest enemy in every single thing in bodybuilding. I'm not just talking about bodybuilding. I'm not talking about training. I'm not talking about mental. I'm not talking about that sort of stuff. I'm talking about your life. Discipline in whatever you do in life. It doesn't have to be bodybuilding, but right now it happens to be bodybuilding. And you just gotta have the discipline. If you don't have the discipline to do something that you don't want to do, and to do that right now, that you know that will get you to the next level of your success in whatever field you have chosen, get that into your head, do that every single fit time. There was a study recently where when you have a thought and you have 1.5 seconds to do the thing that you were thinking about doing, and otherwise you wouldn't do it. Like if you sit on your couch and you remember, oh, I have to do the dishes, and then you sit there for 2 seconds, you won't do the dishes. If you stand up and do the dishes, you will do the dishes, because you don't have the time to think about, oh no, I shouldn't do this because I'm so lazy. You don't thought about your feelings. You thought about, I must do this. So then you go do that. That's the same thing about when you have to go sleeping. You have to sleep to gain a good body, because when you train, you break down your body. And when you sleep, you build it up. You have to eat the right things. And one of those big topics that I also want to point out is alcohol and parties and all of that stuff. It's not good for your brain, is not good for your body. It's just, it's bullshit. And I know it's a hard thing to say, because everyone is doing it, and it's a norm. Everyone is partying, everyone is doing this and that. But you know, if you want to get a body, or if you want to get that thing that you really want to get that no one else can get, I mean, you gotta sacrifice. And that is, for me, has always been the easiest part to sacrifice, because I've always been training my ass off. When I was three, I started playing hockey, and from that point, I thought I was gonna be a hockey player, and I've always been training 3 to 4 times a week, up till I was like 12, and everything started to be like, oh, 5 times a week. And when I was 13, I started to work out in the gym, and I just fell in love. Because, you know, that was the place where I could release all my thoughts and not think about anything. And it wouldn't let me think about anything, because my weights were so heavy that I couldn't focus on anything else but getting that fucking bar up. So for me, that's a safe place, and it's always been easy for me to say no to all of those things that won't gain me anything because of my discipline. So first, let's talk about why alcohol is so bad for you if you're working out. And it's pretty simple. It's not good in any way. It's not good for you. It's not good mentally, because you gotta understand that bodybuilding is life. It has the same principles that life has. It breaks you down only to get up stronger than before. Same thing about your muscles. You break them down to get bigger. Bodybuilding logic is life logics. It's the same principles. It's 100% same. And me personally wanna show my great insight on the outside. Alcohol is a toxin. It is not good for your body. It's not good for your brain. It kills brain cells. That's why you all do these stupid fucking things. And one thing that really pisses me off is that steroids are banned because they make you a different human being, and you might do things that to other people that you wouldn't do if you wasn't on steroids, they say. With that say, I'm not using steroids. I'm a 100% 20-year-old natural bodybuilder, and I'm really proud of that. I'm also not saying that if you do steroids, you're a cheater, because I really don't think so. It's your choice. But we're playing on two different fields, and bodybuilding is allowing those two fields in a way to not compete with each other that other sports can't. We can't have like two different hockey teams and one hockey team is on steroids and the other team is not, because everyone for real will go see the guys on steroids because they have harder tackles, they are faster, they are stronger. It's just the way it is, and you can't blame them for using them, because we are the ones who want to see those hard tackles. We want to see the fastest sprinters. We want to see the highest jumps, and we have maximized our human possibilities of high jumps, fast sprints. And I mean, there's a lot of money involved. So I mean, I understand why people would use steroids. Let's get back to liquor. Steroids are banned on the same terms that alcohol is proven to do to you, because you might not have punched your neighbor if you were sober, but you did. But let's talk about the real fact why liquor and alcohol and whatever you want to call it is bad for you. Let's say I was out yesterday and I was drinking, having some fun, and then the next day I want to go to the gym. That's so fucking stupid, because when you go to the gym, all you do is breaking down your muscles, and your body is wired to keep you alive. And since liquor is a toxin, it wanna get that one out of the way before it starts building up your muscles again that you've broken down. And it doesn't work. You will just go to the gym and then lost more than you gained. Like it's really easy. It's really so fucking stupid. And so many people are doing this. Everyone is drinking, going to the gym and drink. It's so fucking stupid. Period. And it all comes down to discipline. You don't have to drink. You can go to the party, but don't drink. It's easy. Why would you even do that? I can take that in another video, why I don't drink and why that's so easy for me. But I won't take that in this video. So the first thing is discipline. It's really easy. Second thing that I've been asked a lot about on Instagram, since I post a lot of motivational things. You can check me out on Instagram if you want. It's Flexus right here. Easy. You don't have to. I'm just uploading some funny content and some educating content, even though I'm 20. The second biggest thing, I think, is your why. Why do you wake up in the morning going to the gym? Why do you do that? I mean, why do you go down and lift the weights? It's not a funny activity to do. Like, it's pretty boring, just up and down, up and down. It's not funny. So you gotta have a why that you don't have to reveal to anyone. But it's gotta be so big that it keeps you grinding every single day. And you're gonna have to wake you up early in the mornings, and you gotta have to be up late in the nights. You gotta say no to parties, you gotta say no to fast food, you know, all of these things. That's one of the biggest keys to a healthy physique. If your goal is just I want to lose some pounds, I want to lift more in bench press, I want to do this, I want to do that, you know, why do you want to do that? Why? Do you want to look good? How important is that? Why do you want to look good? Is it for someone special? Is it, you know, you just write it down and keep it in your pocket. And whenever you feel like, I don't want to go down. I feel like fast food today. I don't like doing this and that. Pick the note up and read what you wrote. And all of a sudden, I can promise you that you will do that thing that you don't feel like doing. I can promise you 100% you will do that. And if you don't, your why is not good enough. The third thing is more practical. Like, training is 20% of your gains. The other 80% is good sleep and good food. And I'm not saying that you, if let's say you want to lose some pounds, you know, and you eat a lot of candies and you're eating small things all the time. You can't just quit doing that right away. That's one of the things that I really have to point out, is don't quit everything just right away, because you will never keep that up. Most of the people won't do that. If your why is not good enough, you will certainly not do this. So just start small. Start small. Don't have the biggest goals. I mean, you can have one main goal that's really big, that you think that, oh, this will really take me out of my comfort zone. But then you can have smaller mid goals that keeps you in the right direction to reach the big goal. And those goals, you don't have to tell anyone about them. It's, you're doing this for you. Maybe your why is different, but, you know, in the end, we're selfish. The fourth thing is food. Everyone knows that protein builds muscles and carbs gives you energy to work out. When you cut or trying to lose weight, it's really basic. You just gotta use more energy than you put into your body, and it's so easy. It's really easy. But the hard part is, what can you eat? What are you eating? What can you replace with better foods that taste similarly, that do the same thing but are better for your body? Maybe you can go even further and look at it like you're a house and you're building a really good house, and protein is the brick in the walls, and the carbs are the guy who puts the brick in the right position. And then you can look even deeper and really understand that protein are just another block of amino acids, which were then BCAA, and just really understand the basics of what food is good for you, what it does. I mean, food is so important, and sleeping is so important. The weightlifting you're doing is only 20%, but still, that's the focus on every single question that I've had. Of course, there's studies showing what exercises will do you best for chest, and what exercises will build your big legs and all of that. But I just take that in a second, what I usually do. But just really understand how important it is to be ready to sacrifice the bad meals and replace it with good meals, and have a really good night's sleep, which I'm really terrible at sleeping, because I hate sleeping. But it's, you know, I gotta go to bed, because my why, I gotta go to bed. Let's talk about like mass gaining exercises. This is my favorite one, because it's where you can put on a lot of weight and it will show results very fast. But it's the base exercises. I know it's boring, but it's the base exercises. The bench press, the squats, the deadlifts, you know, they are great exercises that a lot of people just forget about. The bench press will give you a popped out big chest, and the squats is just good for your entire body, because you release extra testosterone while having a leg workout, and it will gain the entire body. And deadlift, same thing. The back is a big muscle, you know. it will release a lot of testosterone that will benefit the rest of your body. And that's one thing that a lot of people just forget about. Like, they don't train legs. I used to be one of those people. But then I started to train legs and I was like, fuck, my back is getting big. You know, it's biological. We're created in a way and we can't really escape from that. Just find those things and use them. Just use them. Train legs 3 times a week. You can do that. Sometimes it's 3 times, sometimes it's 2 times. You can do that. And it will literally change the way that your body, the rest of your body will gain. So don't forget about legs, all the young kids out there that want big arms. The fourth and probably the last thing, probably not, because I will probably sit here and talk about something else, is that you gotta understand that everything is a work in progress. No one can tell you to do this, do that, and you will gain this. It's not that simple. They say we all are created equally, and that's just the biggest lie in the world. Like, we're not created equally. I was lying before when I told you that fast food is so important. Of course it is important to most of the people, but I can eat fast food 3 times a week and I won't see a difference. I might feel a difference because that's bad food, but I won't see a difference on my body, on my body fat, because my metabolism is so different from normal people. And you gotta understand, and you gotta really pay attention to what is working for you. All of those things that I'm saying in this video is the things that have been working for me. I want to share that with you because I'm getting so much questions all the time about what I'm doing, how do I get this working? And, you know, it's just, I've been listening to myself and I've been paying a lot of attention what is working for me. What you gotta do is just pay attention and enjoy every single moment. Just enjoy the heavy weights and climbing the bars and completing your goals. Be proud of what you have done, but never satisfied. That's one of the things that I want to say as well. Be proud, but never satisfied. You gotta love what you're doing. You gotta love it. Just take everything that I said into consideration. It's not facts. It's not... Okay, it's some of it's fact, but... You know, take it into consideration and... Try it out by yourself. I mean, I've gotten this far. I'm 20 years old. Full naturally bodybuilding. And I'm really proud of my results. But I'm not satisfied. And I guess that's one thing that people are working out a lot will never be satisfied. And we just gotta enjoy every single moment. We can take off a shirt and everybody's like, yeah. It's really funny. Remember that we live in a good time right now, where we just can go down to the gym, we can go to the store, buy our food, we can even go to some food stores and get real good food cooked for us. It's a good time. We even have supplements, and I can talk about my supplements in another video, but, you know, it's a good time to work out, and it's become a trend to work out hard, and I'm just sharing my experience. I'm young. I know I'm young, but I think I'm on the right track at least. And, you know, I've been accomplishing a lot of things that I never thought was possible. Just I'm 20 and I'm a fitness ambassador. I'm fitness modeling. I'm doing this and that, and I'm going to represent Alex Jamal's Power Drink in Sweden. It's a big fucking honor, and I love that guy. Just check that guy out. He's been a lot of help, and he's a personal trainer in LA, and he's a big profile in the industry, and he's been doing men's physique for years and competing. He's an amazing guy. Just check him out, and hope you guys really enjoyed this video, and I see you guys in the next one.